Hey guys, Rudy here. As you see here, I'm working on a 1968 Aristocrat landliner belonging to friends of ours from Aristocrats Anonymous, Jose and Rene Gonzalez. They brought it in for some work. Here you see the back of their water heater, which is the old water heater. Here you see the front of it. It's the old type. Got a big grill, ugly, it wasn't working. After taking it out, this is what it looks like. Underneath can accumulate a lot of dirt. You guys don't realize how much dirt can accumulate, so I just wanted to show you. Here's the water heater out. Now here you see the water heater out, but also the two pipes that I needed to preserve and put on the new one, and you'll see them on the new one in a little bit. Here I noticed that the wood underneath where the water heater went in was pretty bad. Here you see the water tank. The water tank has some numbers that are valuable. This is a 20-gallon tank. Now this is underneath the dinette on one side to get to the water tank or to see it. Here I'm exposing the water tank, and also you see some wires, excuse me. What I was looking for here is actually fuses, but this unit did not have any fuses. So here you see me starting to install new fuses. Okay, we're back to the new water heater. Here we have the new water heater slid in, getting ready to mount it. Use some tape to hold things, and then I put the butyl tape and then the screws. You'll see the new screws. There is another view of it from afar, how it fits in. This is the back side. Now that yellow pipe that you see there is a gas line, a new gas line. When I went underneath to hook up the new gas line, I noticed that there was a gap between the skin, the outside skin, and the actual framing of the trailer, so I needed to put it back. So there you see the new screws after pushing it back, holding it in place, and mounting the screws in place to hold a skin. Now here you'll see the new gas line hooked up, came out from the top, and then also a small little overflow tube that came out. This is the gas line again. Jumping over to some new fans that they wanted installed. There they are. There's one of them installed. This is just over the kitchen area. And that little arrow is showing you where the new little conduit, because I could not get inside the wall, not without removing the skin. Now this is the other location. This is inside of a cabinet. And this is running that wire through the back closet and then into the wiring system. This is the new fuse area, finishing up some wiring. Another shot of that. A little more complicated now because they've got some new things, but now they also have fuses. This is the back side of the water heater. Now this is the new water heater, and you'll see that the pipes are marked, showing the next person that gets to work on it, and it could be myself, how everything is piped in and working. All new clamps, new pipes, new fittings. Now this is some of the old fittings here, and what I'm doing, I'm checking for leaks because I was taking pictures of the pipes as I was running water pressure through. No leaks. Here you see the flame testing the water heater. You see the blue flame. There's a little red arrow showing you the blue flame.
Okay, water heater is on. There There's the flame. We're gonna leave it on. We're gonna warm up some water. See how that goes.
Here's the over the stove fan.
The switch gets stuck. It works. It just gets stuck every once in a while. So you have to play with it. But it's working. As you can see, there it is. Alrighty, it's powered up. Power wasn't connected, but it's working now. So let me try it one more time. There it is. Got you a new chain, the whole thing. All right, talk to you later. Bye.
Now here, they had a concern about some leaks, and this is the gray water lever, and it was leaking. I think I caught a drop here coming out. I think it's right there. Here are these two gaskets that needed to be replaced after tearing apart the valve, put in replacing. There's torn apart. Here you see the pipe with its new clamp. Now we jumped over to the wiring. This is finishing up the wiring. Put in a battery charger and a new battery. Didn't have a 12-volt system before. These old trailers, if you wanted 12-volt power, you had to plug in your car sometimes if it didn't have a battery, and this did not have a battery. This was used to store the hoses, and so what I did is I divided up this area, as you can see there. Here it's all finished up. You can see the door of the water heater up, and same with that compartment all closed up. Hey, I want to thank Jose and Renee for choosing me to work on their trailer. It was a challenge. It was fun. It was hopefully it all came out the way they wanted it. So talk to you guys later. Thanks for watching the video, guys, and we'll see you guys soon.